This episode is a tribute to my dear and personal friend, Leonard Cohen, who passed away this week. I had the pleasure of getting 10 pages of writing to him once upon a time, and an invitation, personal invitation, to go and join him for dinner. And it's been a remarkable gift to be able to sit and spend time with your idol. They say the one who you respect and admire most is either going to be so commonplace, so much like you, that it just flows seamlessly, or that they'll be a total asshole. And he was the former. Certainly the former, not the latter. One of the things he said to me, we're talking about women, we talked about everything from Buddhism, Zen, to women, money, and writing, of course. We were talking about one of the lines I use here, the 10,000 lonely nights and the myth of me as a ladies' man. And I asked him, do you miss anyone? And he said, I don't miss anyone. Or really, what about love? What about consummating? What about time together? What about companionship? Yes, companionship is lovely. And then when you're not with someone, do you miss it? And he said to me, he looked over and he said, I don't miss anyone, he said. And he didn't say it to make a point, he just said it as a matter of fact. And so at this time, where in his passing, there's a lot of writing about, I miss him, we're going to miss you. But that's not it. If Leonard has aroused some sense of light, some sense of personal truth in you, then in moments of darkness or moments of simplicity, then those moments, they belong to you. We are the dreaming, the suffering, the bliss. We are the thing that he writes about. And so whatever vision you have of the things that touched you so much, you only can understand them because you've encountered them already for yourself. The saying is, you wouldn't have found me if you didn't know me already. How would you know to look for me? And they say that about all great writing, and Jesus too. That's a whole other thing. If it be your will. Gratitude, appreciation, in that we dwell.
Hey.
Hi.
You look tired.
Yeah.
What did you do last night?
It's true. Worked on the second trip.
Worked on the what? What's the other job?
Waitress.
Yeah? Oh my god.
And, why do you look at me with those puppy dog eyes?
Why is it puppy dog eyes? I'm listening to you.
So I had a question for you. Do you know what it is?
What?
I have a question for you. Do you know what it is?
No.
That's the question.
So, what's the question is?
That, oh, now you're asking me a question. You're so
complex. No!
Answer the question with another question.
Maybe, sometimes.
Sometimes. You Ukrainian girls.
What? I meant what?
Huh?
And what?
I met a Ukrainian girl yesterday.
Zhuzhu.
Zhuzhu?
Zhuzhu.
Tu parles français?
J-U, J-U. No, I'm Ukrainian.
Yeah?
I think I fell in love.
Really?
No. Get the money and the passports back up. Bring half what you brought from the last spot. So, Ukraine and you?
Russia? Don't worry, I'll tell you later. Just hurry and meet me at the terminal. Take a feeling like your head might pop off. Brain dead and you're scared that your heart stop.
It's a very Helmut Newton moment. Heart stop, keep chasing. You'll catch a lady. She's waiting to show her crazy.
Back up, bring half what you brought from the last spot. Don't worry,
Wow, my neck was only so nimble. I tented out last night at the top of this apartment here in Lower East Side, Manhattan. Some motherfucker shooting glue balls out of the top of that building. There's one right there. The tent filled up with water pretty good last night. I'm gonna try to hit the gym soon. I'll go for a swim or something. I could really use a shower and a shave. Oh, a little poop.
New York City goals. Take a break from the tent and find a real bed tonight. Or a person with a real bed who doesn't shoot glue balls.
Excuse me. Let's have a conversation.
Say what?
Are you just striking a pose for me? Now, where are you coming from?
America?
Where are you coming from in the last moment with your BlackBerry? Is there any information here that's going to give you away?
Nope.
What are you doing? What's your name?
Kathy?
Hey, I'm Andrew.
Andrew, nice to meet you.
Yeah, you're lovely.
All right, thank you.
And do you want an apple? They have all these apples at the market here.
Okay.
Okay, let's go buy you an apple. So let's hear about your childhood. Look, you found an apple.
Take a picture.
Good. It's on me today.
Okay. Thanks for the apple?
Yeah, wait, I don't work here.
Oh.
I'm buying you an apple.
Oh.
And then who are you?
I'd rather have the money.
You want money? Here, go buy yourself an apple. You have to go pay for it though. You want a dollar?
Thank you. You know my name?
Kathy.
K-A-T-H-Y.
Double Bump Confidential.
And when are we going for drinks?
What?
When are we going for drinks?
Give me your card or something.
Write my number down. What?
I can't get my number out.
Why? It's your boyfriend?
It's not my phone.
Your boyfriend told you that?
Yeah, I guess.
So I'll call you.
No.
Just give me your number and I'll call you and then you'll have my number. You want to take my number?
Yeah.
Okay, it is 646.
Okay.
425-70. But I'm thinking, I'm serious here. This is like sex, drinks, the whole thing. Like
sex, moving in. Got it.
Yeah. I want it all.
Oh, well, got my picture, so.
Did I give you the number?
I don't know. Yeah. K-A-T-H-Y.
What a hot body.
She was definitely on something. She was ready to sell anything on the spot. I wasn't offering anything either.
I'll make you famous.
I still can't believe that crack whore, she stole my dollar.
As he runs anxiously for new salvation, the tent looms in young travel bum's mind.
Say something quick.
What?
Say something about the cookie. Now, before
so
you swallow.
Good. I love you.
Now, not only was that with a cookie accent, it was also something European or South American. It's hard to say.
I'm from Brazil.
Where do you go with all these cookies? What's the future?
I have to run, sorry.
But you have to give me your phone number so I can take you for a drink.
Hi.
You're over there, it don't matter.
Now. Poof, I'm here. What are your other two wishes? Didn't work so good.
I guess I have to find out what girls are looking for in this city. Let me do some rapid fire research.
Here we go.
Most guys are assholes, and I think it's because they have lots of options of beautiful girls.
Here we go.
Everybody's always trading up in this town.
Capitalism is not the logic of monogamy.
Mr. Cab Driver.
It's easy to meet a woman in New York.
That's not easy.
How do you find a good woman?
Pray to the God.
You guys think it's easy to find a guy who's reliable?
No. You need someone new, you're going to the next person.
But if you have the love of God in you, you're not supposed to cheat.
We're more willing to compromise. Unacceptable. We're strong women.
What kind of videos that they're taking?
Adult internet. You know what I mean?
No.
No, it's like porn.
Oh, yeah. It's good.
Yeah, this moment right now, yeah, they call it the money shot.
Thank you. Money shot.
It's 646-425. Oh, you were trying to guess?
I'm a mind reader, actually.
I think I'm in love. So now that we're hitting it off so well, what's your name?
This is my girlfriend, actually.
You're fibbing again!
Yeah.
My name's Andrew. Hi, my girlfriend.
Hey.
That's not your name. It's just... Okay, I get it. You guys doing any shows?
No, we're just in town seeing friends.
I have no idea.
Oh yeah. Where are you from?
Texas.
Norway.
You're from Norway? Did you say Norway?
Do you have Pinocchio-itis?
Uh-huh.
Oh dear.
You don't seem to sound very Norwegian. She's swift. Norwegians are amazing.
No, yeah. Really, I'm from Iowa and we have agencies.
You look a little bit like Ashton Kutcher.
Yeah. I get that actually.
Do you?
Well, have a good day.
Yeah, you guys have a great day.
Thanks for you.
Bye. I'm Andrew. And you guys are my girlfriend and see ya.
This isn't really my girlfriend either.
Okay, that's a beautiful girl. This is the trouble with New York, you know? A beautiful girl in New York, she's a model, you know? Beautiful girl in New York, she's an agent. A beautiful girl, she's not available. She's not even available to be a girl.
But props to her for being so savvy on the pickup. Nevertheless, it reminds me how American girls have a particularly vigorous habit of lying. What are we hiding in those supersized smiles? I'm always amazed how traditional cultures don't cushion their words as much as Americans. Go to Russia or Serbia and ask a girl for her number, and if she doesn't like you, she'd be like, "No, I'm not interested. Go away." Or probably she'd be like, "No, I'm not interested. Go away." Is it because the old American frontier land was vast and feral? You couldn't trust the law? Every man for herself, disorienting, devil may care, and wild. Is that when we learned our phony smiles to find safety in the vulnerable open frontier? Man had a gun for safety, woman was packing a smile. America, bigger, faster, stronger. And meanwhile, we can't even tell a guy to fuck off properly. But hey, let's call a spade here. New York City models are carefully trained by their agents to say that they're not in town long enough to give out their numbers. And, oh, yeah, this girl just wasn't into me.
Homelessness in New York. I didn't hear that. So I just walked up 6 flights of stairs. I'm gonna go check out this new place. Hopefully, I have a place to stay for a month in New York.
Are you Andrew?
Yeah, hi.
Hi, I'm Kayla.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Kayla looks like Brooke Shields and... Oh my God. And who tells you that? Everyone?
I've gotten that before, yeah. I don't see it.
You don't?
I need to look like Brigitte Bardot in like a week for the Halloween.
You're shooting for that?
Yeah.
What's the occasion?
Well, I'm bartending on Halloween.
Oh, okay.
It's fantastic. And my whole restaurant is going 60s, so what? I got voted to be Brigitte Bardot, even though I don't look like her. So no. I need to like make magic happen in the next week.
Awesome. I think you can do it.
I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Perfect.
Bye, Andrew.
Take care of that. She almost took me out. We got 1 million views. About to drink 1 billion brews.
Yeah, yeah. In honor of the millionth view on YouTube. Jake, we gon' wake and bake. I make papes when I when I battle all you fakes for cake.
I wear this shit out in the hood and all.
Stand up. So this is like your everyday apparel. You wearing your big bling normally?
Nah, I just wear my bullshit. White t-shirts, black t-shirts, jeans, and sneakers.
Could you ever see yourself wearing this?
Never.
Never? Would you ever let anyone you know wear this?
If they want to get shot in the hood, then that happens, you know?
This is Emily Crouch, editor extraordinaire, French Vogue.
Once upon a time.
But what I love is the moment, you know? Like where everything comes together and then...
I'm on a Uma. I'm traveling slowly.
What shore are you going to?
Rosicha.
What?
Rosicha.
You're really pretty. You're very welcome. You're not gonna just guess my number, but.
You're right. Oh, well.
Here, it's much easier this way. Punch that into your phone. I saw you punching away. You have adorable little thumbs.
I do?
What's your name?
Huh?
What's your name?
Summer.
Are you actually from California or?
No.
What do you like to do besides talking to me typically?
Working.
Yeah? In fashion?
No.
Steamrolling.
Sorry, what?
You're a steamroller?
No.
No? Are you a... just say yes?
Say yes.
You think I can still hit on you while you're typing? It's hard to say. I wonder if I just keep texting, he'll go away. Although he did make me laugh. Probably has a small one, though. Then again, small penises are super underrated these days. We're at the front line of 14 billion years of the universe existence. No one has ever been here before. Doesn't that just make you feel free? The past doesn't exist. We're totally creating the world. Doesn't that just make you want to grab me and do crazy things? I think I'm in love. Am I gonna trust you to call me or what?
I don't know. For what purpose would I call you?
Lovemaking? Coffee? Tea?
Are they letting people in for the show yet?
I think so, yeah.
You think so yet? Or
yeah.
You don't think so yet?
They are. Well, look, there's anybody can go in there if you have a pass.
I'm gonna have a pass. But the actual. Where
what?
Do I go? I've never been to one.
Just go in.
Just go in?
Just go in, and then they'll ask you for your invite.
This is the main one?
Yeah! Just go, just walk in.
And a little awkward.
Yeah.
It's a little awkward
walking. Walk you up there.
This woman in yellow walking. Happy
to. You know, I think the mistake I made there was not just giving her my phone and say, here, you know, put your number in there. It was fun talking with you. She seemed like she was good for a little laugh, though. I think sometimes, you know, I feel pretty courageous going up to a girl and talking to her because I do really feel that we are just dust in the wind, just seeing it for what it is. And deep down inside, she is vulnerable just like me. Anyway, back to work.
Yo, spitting lyrics over this music, that is my calling. Rappers stepping to me, eventually they be falling. East Coast to the West Coast, you hauling. King of City.
You a great shot of you, like going like this. It's funny. Hey, Natasha.
Hi, Nachi, N-H-U-Y.
So far, looks like another night alone in the tent.
So I'm back in the tent. I got a key from this girl on the fifth floor at the top of this building. We were dating, and we were boning anyway, and she said I could stay here. So far, New York's a pretty lonely place, I gotta say. There's so much social opportunity, which for me anyway means so much social disappointment. It's like there's so many carrots wagging in front of Donkey Boy here. It's not like the countryside where, you know, it's peace already. Here you have to make peace. Think of Leonard Cohen. He said, the myth of me as a ladies' man kept me warm during 10,000 nights alone or something like that.
I remember you well in the Chelsea Hotel.
Poetry is gone
in New York. The Chelsea days are over. New York is really just a place for business, you know, and glamour dreams with all the disappointments of corporations and personal mediocrity. The new center of the world is what's going on in the developing world, where New York City has dumped its hopes and young economies. I'd like to see what kind of tree grows in Brazil.
Those were the reasons that was New York. Yeah, but you got away, didn't you, babe?
I find I've never heard girls complain so much about the guys in New York and how they're so unfaithful. I would never try to have a girl friend in New York. I find if I'm not dating two girls a week or something, I'm bouncing into walls. It's too stimulating here.
I need you. I don't need you. And all of them jiving around.
The strange thing is that these well-meaning girls get dressed up in the same uniform, you know, the high heels and the blouse, a tight pair of jeans, gearing themselves up for predictable disappointment. When all the while, New York is kind of like a fuck mill.
I mean, maybe a lot of women do just want a bone, but who in life really knows what they want? All these girls born innocently into their bodies and in some way or other disappointed with them.
Sometimes I feel sad for New York City. People pointing their carts east when they really want to go west.
Who are oppressed by the figures of beauty. You fixed yourself. You said, well, never mind. We are ugly, but we have the music.
Maybe I should go to South America and learn what it is to be hungry like in the old New York City days. The richer desperation of becoming. Find me a nice loyal girl who comes to me with dirty fingernails and none of that glamour ambition bullshit. Latch on to me with a couple of kids. No.
You just turn your back on the crowd. You got a way I never once heard you say. I need you. I don't need you. I need you. I don't need you.
All this is what I love about New York, too.
I don't mean to suggest that I loved you the best. I can't keep track of each fallen robin. I remember you well in the Chelsea Hotel. That's all, I don't even think of you that often.
Oh, where's that post office? You know where the post office is? Post office? It's called the Royal Enfield. Are you into biking?
I don't ride myself, but I have heard some rides.
Yeah, yeah. What kind of bikes are you into?
I like Ducatis now.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, my name is Anna.
Anna. Okay, cool. Andrew.
All the said
excuse me, are you modeling?
What?
Are you modeling?
I'm on my way to a casting.
What's your name?
Aaron,
right on, I'm Andrew. Give me your contact info.
I'm Aaron, I'm from South Dakota. My phone number is
60- I'm missing all the stars.
Where's the fucking post office?
Woohoo!
I see postal trucks.
It was fashion week and models were everywhere. But really, something wasn't right inside.
All the sad young men.
Let's go. So you think you can tell? Heaven forbid.
The night fell, but then, what are the chances of this?
I got you.
Good.
What's going on?
Nothing.
Yeah, don't be shy. I can't remember your name though.
Lonnie.
Yeah. Lonnie from Ohio.
No, that's
from
Courtney.
Indiana.
Courtney's from Ohio. I'm from Texas.
How you doing?
Good.
Good?
Yeah.
Wanna see what it looks like to be you and me?
Yay, we're cute.
So what have you been doing?
I was looking at luggage.
Okay, are you planning to go away?
Yeah, I leave tomorrow.
Now, if I recall correctly, you don't even live here. 5-week vacation?
Yeah.
You crashing Shea Courtney?
Do what?
Have you been crashing Shea Courtney?
No, I've been staying with some other friends of mine.
Yeah?
Are you New Yorker?
How am I? Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, no. Well, a little bit, but then again, not exactly, but if you really, I can't even explain it. You're not a very curious type, are you?
No.
Lonnie.
So.
You can dance.
In the storm?
You
feeling
it?
No.
So when are we gonna get married? You have a beautiful smile. You really do. How tall are you?
5'11".
Really?
I really like these with the studs.
Now all you need is a stud. Okay, I'm gonna turn this off so we can do things that we're not allowed to show on camera.
And you're wondering, did this go anywhere?
No.
What's up?
What's up?
The most beautiful girl talking, sitting down next to this cool guy.
Just waiting.
Do you guys know each other or are you just kind of like cock blocking?
No, this is my girlfriend.
Like tonight it would be nice to find a girl who isn't another model and maybe get a room and not sleep in the tent tonight. Excuse me, this is totally random, but you walked by and I was like, you smell so good.
Oh, thanks.
I wanted to just say hello. What is it called, by the way?
It's Juicy Couture.
Oh, okay. And I like your like extended
lashes. Thanks.
What's your name?
Kristen.
What are you up to? Dinner? Lunch?
Yeah, just meeting a friend for dinner.
You have a great body to your hair.
Thank you. Okay.
So complimentary. My name's Andrew.
Hi. Nice
and I want to take you for a drink sometime if you're free.
Okay, sure.
Cool. What's your digits, as they say?
914.
In New York, you can connect with someone in seconds. It all happens so fast, just as fast as you can forget them in the next second.
1-803.
You seem like you're kind of rushing, are you?
That I'm rushing?
Rushing.
Oh, rushing. No, I'm just going to meet my girlfriend, Blair.
Kristen.
Yeah.
It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I can't remember her name. Who do people say you look like?
Who do people say I look like?
Yeah.
Angelina Jolie.
No.
I guess Jessica Biel.
What?
Jessica Biel.
I'm thinking of this blonde girl. Don't get too flattered, but she's a Victoria's Secret model. She has like a.
Oh,
she's
Czech.
The big nose.
Yes.
But anyway.
Karolina Kurkova.
Yeah. Karolina Kurkova.
Wait, I need you too. Except, I don't want to get your picture, I'd rather get your phone number. I met you on the street once, and we almost went on a date.
I don't think so,
no,
we didn't
sure.
go on a date. But you know, I'm
you
engaged.
Now you're engaged.
I never invited you up.
I'm flattered.
I swear to God,
I would know. I remember who I'm with.
Well, I'm only here for break. I go back to school on a Tuesday.
Oh no.
Well, I can't do any more damage around this popsicle stand. I'm out of here!
So that was it. I got back on the bike and I was thinking, whatever. As long as the water dried out of the tent, I'll be fine tonight. But then I saw this girl, walking really slowly. I just hoped she wasn't another model. Just a simple girl.
How come you're so casual today?
What do you mean?
You seem like
so at peace and so un-New York-y?
Because I just started meditating, and like, if you saw me like 2 months ago, I'd be looking really angry and rushing to work. I work at Webster, by the way.
You work at what?
Webster.
Oh, yeah. Cool. So you're having like a transformation.
Yeah. I feel really happy all the time.
Wow.
Yeah. I used to do a lot of drugs and then I stopped. No drugs or drinking.
Sometimes I feel like it's all a dream here, just watching everything rummage around like ants, you know? I just want to chill out and read poetry like New York used to be, you know?
Yeah.
You know, sometimes I think, you know, people are just designed to eat, sleep, and fuck. And there's art, which is just a form of fucking anyway.
Good call.
Here we are, all dust, all stars. Old heart catcher with a moonshine jar. Lost in a dream as we tried to retrieve pieces from yesterday. What will they be? Open the box, inside there's a stream. Your skin is the air and your blood sings on. What will it be? Ambling ambrosia, casting your seeds. Come on, the road you're on. The darkness flowers into the dawn. Digital daylight, electronic stars, primitive eyes, an old-fashioned art, nostalgically.
Yeah, I'm out at Brooklyn, now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow, but I'll be hood forever.
Well, there you have it. New York is the place where you can make it the biggest, but it's the hardest. And where maybe everyone wants independence so much that they're willing to sacrifice relationships. In American, we call this a booty call. You know, you never really know when you take a number. You get these great Walmart smiles, and girls will often just give their number simply to get out of the discomfort of being around a stranger. It's a big open field of try 'em on and trade 'em up in New York City. And doesn't it start in high school? Before the kids can even wipe their asses, they discover the gold rush of everyone fucking everyone. And where therefore no one really matters. Except for the kids who aren't fucking anyone. The real majority, that is, who are already convinced they don't matter anyway. Anyway, everyone's doubtful about whether or not they're really loved or really safe to love in this hit it and quit it frontier. I'm pretty sure that American girls invented the fuck 'em before they fuck you policy, which runs wild in Manhattan. Half the time, New York women make sure that you go to their house for one night stands so that she keeps her comfort, her emotional safety, and the power to kick you out. I can only imagine that New York has the most hollow-feeling walk of shame of any city, despite and because of its magnificent anonymity. So we lie a little, to cover our asses, to protect ourselves in the open plains. In my travels, I've wondered whether the American folk are very alone compared with traditional cultures, where folk don't have the same luxury to sacrifice for individualism. 20 million strangers in a can of sardines is New York. The New World feels more alone, and New Yorkers are the most alone of them all. The film comes to a sweet end, and I mount my horse and ride off into the sunset on a hamster wheel of endless likes on YouTube.
Nigga, I be spiked out. I could trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I most definitely from.
Great to watch that old episode. Clearly a lot of angst and cynicism in the heart of a young man. Nevertheless, I learned a lot. I relearned a lot from him. But in the end, the travel bum comes to be a man who is creating himself in every situation, who doesn't even see geography, who sees the human condition trying to work itself out, trying to understand itself in its various climate, in its various circumstances, wherever they are. There's always adaptation that evolves appropriate or according to whatever place it's in. The contexts are all different. The cultures are all different. But the very human longing, the human self-understanding, the desire for self-preservation, the desire to adapt, the desire to find itself and connect and thrive is itself the same wherever you go. And then when you start to see that, you see the human vulnerability, you see the human longing in everyone, right? But you first have to see it in yourself in order to identify it truly in everyone else. Otherwise, you just get caught up in the permutations and the formation of an angry person. Oh, he's angry. No, that's a person who's trying to understand himself. That's a person who's upset, who's resentful, who had something bad happen to them. You don't take things personally anymore. So this is a young man who's taking things personally. And travel bum of today is quite a different creature. Stay tuned.